दिस इज द क्विक अनबॉक्सिंग वीडियो ऑफ सोनी HDR PJ410. दिस इज अ न्यू एडिशन टू सोनीज PJ लाइनअप्स विच इंक्लूड्स अ प्रोजेक्टर इन द हैंडीकैम. सो दिस पर्टिकुलर मॉडल हैज NFC एंड Wi-Fi सर्टिफाइड एंड इट हैज 9.2 मेगापिक्सल स्टिल इमेज रिकॉर्डिंग, 35x ऑप्टिकल जूम एंड 60x क्लियर इमेज जूम एंड इट ऑल्सो हैज 26.8 mm वाइड एंगल लेंस एंड यू कैन रिकॉर्ड द वीडियोज अप टू 50 Mbps हाई बिट रेट एंड ड्यूअल वीडियो रिकॉर्डिंग. सो लेट्स ओपन द बॉक्स एंड सी व्हाट सोनी ऑफर्स. We have the usual Sony documents. Operating guides in several different languages. I don't even know what all these languages are. And one looks like Chinese. And we do have luckily English guide as well. It tells you about how to insert the memory card, battery, etc. And I just forgot to mention, this camera came with a 16 GB free memory card from Sony and a carrying case. I will show them to you right now. So apart from this, okay, we have the 16 GB memory card here. Let's open it. Okay, we will keep it aside. What else is in the box? Here is the camera and we have the charger and the charging adapter specific to India, and we have a readily available HDMI cable, a mini port. This is the very standard package that Sony always comes up with, nothing new in it. It's just that in India, I'm not sure if this offer is available in all the countries, but in India, if you buy this phone, the Handycam, then you will get 16 GB micro SD card free and a carrying case. Carrying case is also really nice. I will show it to you in a while. And the charger is a standard USB charger. It goes like this. And here is the carrying case I got along with this Sony Handycam. This Handycam costs around 32,900 online. I purchased it in one of the Sony centers in Banshankri, Bangalore, and I paid 31,500 rupees. So I got a good discount there. Bag is really nice and very high quality. It has two compartments, one for the camera, and probably in this new compartment you can keep the additional battery, etc., if you have any. So let's keep the bag aside, let's look at the camera itself. This is very light indeed. I never imagined it will be so light. Focus. So it records in full HD 1080p. So as I explained, this is the projector. This is the lens, Carl Zeiss. and it has symbols of NFC, micro SD card and Wi-Fi. This is the hand strip where you can record the videos. It's very convenient. All the buttons are accessible. So when you are holding it like this, this is the stop and start recording button. And it has also an inbuilt USB cable. So this is where you connect. So your charger can be connected here, or else you can connect it to a laptop and charge it as well along with data transfer, just like the new smartphones. Oh, and I forgot to open the battery. Probably it's still in the box. Yes, he's here. NPBX1. So let's insert the battery and start the device. I will show you. This is for tripod. I don't know what this is meant for. And you have a multi-purpose USB port here. So probably you can transfer data from this. So once I test that, I will upload more details about this in my next video. Yeah, that's about it. And we have very less buttons. There are no much dedicated buttons except for taking a still image while recording the video. And this is the zoom lever. So if you turn it right, then it will zoom in, and then left will be zoom out. And this particular button here, you can adjust the clarity of the projector output. So I will show that in my full review video of this camera. And it has extended clear 60x zoom. It's really nice. I've not tested it yet. Let's see how it's gonna be. So here we insert the battery. Okay. As the symbol goes, this arrow should be the left. And it locks here, it's pretty nice. Let's open the screen. Okay, as you see, you don't have any on or off buttons in this camera. Once you open the screen, it will automatically turn on. And then once you close it, it will turn off automatically. So it's really hassle-free. You don't have to worry about turning off the device every time. And here are some ports. This is the speaker. And HDMI out. You can directly connect and then stream the videos from this video camera to a TV or your laptop or any HDMI enabled device. And the best part is this projector does not only play from within the video camera. You can also connect the external devices with this mini HDMI port and then play the videos via this projector. So this is where the memory card goes. So you just have to push it and you will know with this red button that it is detected. So let's close it. And it's all black because I've not yet opened the lens cover. Okay. So here it is. Pretty nice and clear. And on the screen, this is not a touch screen. You have to control everything using this joystick. I will show the features in my next video. And this is the play and open media button. And we have the projector button here.
If you press this, you can stream your recorded videos on the projector. That's about the overview of this camera. Please stay tuned, and I will be uploading another video with full review of this camera features, functions, and the video quality and image quality. Thank you for watching.